Hi, welcome back down to the basement once again. It's Dan Veall here, and this is Guitar Interactive Magazine. Now, we have here the Mayones B4 in Ash. Let's get up to the headstock and we'll have a closer look at the instrument and have a little listen to the kind of sounds that it's got on board. Okay, moving up the top here. Really nice, tasty headstock here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to flip the bass over, so you can have a look at the back of the headstock, as we usually do. Look at this. That's pretty tasty. We have got a mahogany and maple neck. What I like about this is that it's a little unusual. You usually see, say, a maple neck with mahogany stringers. But it's the other way around. We've got this lovely mahogany neck. Absolutely brilliant. It's an angled back, so no need for string trees. So if I just flip the bass over, you can see that as I go over. You can see the headstock is angled back. And four nice, standard, enclosed, lightweight keys. Running up, we have a Graphtec nut here. And then we're going to come down, rosewood fretboard, and 24 absolutely perfect frets. No markers on the front of the fretboard here, so it's absolutely lovely and clean. And if I just roll the bass forward, we've got some nice simple little markers on the top of the neck there. And whilst we're moving down the neck, we'll just flip the bass over, have a look at the back as well. Because I want you to see this. This is really cool. So not only do we have this absolutely beautiful bit of swamp ash for the body, bolt on, let's have a look at this. I really like this cutaway here. Hopefully you can see it if I just move it in the light. Really nice cutaway here, which makes the whole heel really shallow. And you get your fingers right in there. And the thumb up here whilst you're playing quite high up on the neck. Nice big cutaway here as well, and the corners are really nicely rounded. Battery compartments and a compartment for electronics and the like. Flipping the bass over again. There we go. Okay, and then the cutaways are also up on the front of the bass body as well. So round here we've got this lovely cutaway here, and round here around the top edges. There's like a nice little sort of bevel going around here as well, around the instrument. The body itself feels really, really thin. It actually feels really, really snug to the body. Very well balanced, weighing in at around 4 kilos. So this bass weighs practically nothing. Okay, going around, this is what I like. Nice quick release bridge here. String from the back straight over to the headstock, and string changes are going to be an absolute breeze. As for electronics, a pair of Aguilar DCB pickups. These are dual rail pickups. Absolutely brilliant. I really like these. I've upgraded one of my own basses with these pickups, and it's taken on a whole new life. And that zing, that character you can hear in the intro video, is definitely got to be something to do with these as well. They're brilliant, very nice. Round electronics wise, Mayones' own electronic circuit. I believe it's the GB BP3 preamp. We have master volume, pan control between the two pickups. We have a master mid-range boost and cut. Bass and treble on stack here, and then a nice passive tone control as well for that final bit of extra adjustment. There's also a pull switch on the volume control, which means that you can switch the whole bass from the active circuit straight to passive. And we're going to hear that as well. So I'm going to quickly buzz through all of the sounds available on the instrument. We've got quite a lot of controls here, so I'm going to give you a brief run through. But I'll certainly try and explain some more information in the written review in the magazine as well. Okay, so master volume up. I'm going to set everything flat. Nice, the three-band EQ, they have center clicks, so you can find your zero point, and the master tone is all the way open, so you're getting all that lovely top end as well. You heard both pickups in the intro, so I'm going to wind and I'm going to listen to just the front pickup on its own. Here we go. Some different playing styles all rolled into one. Here we go. Really nice, clear, open sound. The whole instrument sort of resonates and sounds really, really rich, even with just a single pickup on. Okay, let's wind it back and listen to the bridge pickup soloed. Here we go. Similar kind of thing again. Plenty of zing, plenty of bite, and not too much low-end loss as well. Sometimes you'll get a bridge pickup being a bit close to the bridge, and you know, you get all that lovely bite, but you tend to lose maybe a little bit of the instrument's low-end. Now, hopefully you can hear this in the studio. You've got that lovely bite coming through your speakers, but there's still the wood character of the instrument being able to come through as well. Okay, I'm going to level it off, go back to both pickups at the same time, and then very quickly just give you a run through what these controls are doing. As I said, they're all flat at the moment, and the best way I can do this is play a bit, nudge the control, play a bit, nudge the control, and then talk about it after. Okay, so this is the mid control. This is what it sounds like in its current position with fingerstyle. So, boost and then cut. There's a great little spot there. I pulled the mid control back and it just sounds really, really big and meaty. So there's a nice frequency setting on that mid control. Let's go and have a look at the stacked bass and treble. So same again, we're back to zero. And I'm gonna start with the bass control. I'll zip that up and then pull it back down again. Here we go. Tons of low end, really nice. I like this preamp. This is really cool. It's got a nice control to it. Boosting the lows on this four string sound really great without sounding mushy. Cutting away, brilliant for say solo work where you wanna just chop away that low end, get rid of any resonance so you can go off and play like a nice sweet melody over the top and then back to where you were to carry on playing. Okay, so. That leaves us with the treble cut and boost. Just gonna make sure the bass control is back to zero. Okay, so same again. This is in the flat position. So that wasn't boosted all the way and it wasn't wound off all the way. That was about, you know, about a quarter of a turn round from zero in each direction. So you can tell already there's a lot of cut and boost there on that top control. If you want to tear people's heads off with a crazy slap bass solo, then go for the treble control and watch some ears bleed. No, honestly, it's very, very cool. It's very, very clear. There's a lot of boost there. But it makes things sound really, really percussive, and that's a really cool thing, obviously, for us bass players. Okay, finally then, we have got the passive tone control on the end. I'm gonna do pretty much the same, but this time what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna boost the treble and bass just a little bit, just to give it a bit of extra character, so you can hear the instrument in that setting before I wind off the top end with the passive control. Okay, here we go then. Thank you. And there you have it. So I played with the tone control all the way open, half closed, and then full closed. So you got a 50% off, and then all of the top end rolled off on this particular control. And I played some different styles there, just so you could still hear what it was doing to the top end. So finger style, rounded off, sounded nice and mellow. And then a little bit of slap style, if you want to call it that. The top end was nicely muted, but you still had that nice punch, and the mid-range was still allowed to come through. So you got still a little bit of mid-range bite in there as well. Okay, so that pretty much rounds it off for the controls. As I said, this is a fairly quick run through of all the different settings, but to be honest, you could be here for absolutely ages, even with just the pan control, nudging it forward a bit or nudging it back. So you had that kind of 40-60 kind of setting with the front and back pickups. And there's a wide range of sounds available on this really cool instrument. Now, as I said earlier on, it's very, very well balanced. It doesn't want to go anywhere. It sits on my leg nice and easily. And it has a really nice, slim, comfortable neck. I've got fairly large hands, but I think even with a fairly smaller palms, you're not gonna have any problems with getting around this instrument at all. I like Mayones, they're a really cool brand, and this is certainly another very cool instrument from them. So if you can get a chance to try one of these out, then by all means do so. Let me know how you get on, because I think they're really, really cool. As per usual, I always say this, I'll put some information in the written review, a bit more about Mayones and this particular instrument. And of course, thank you very much for watching, and of course I'll catch up with you again soon. Thanks ever so much for watching.